My name is Jayamani Dalanani and I am going to discuss our India's 11th Prime Minister Inder Kumar Gujral, who was known and on at 2 a.m. that you are the Prime Minister of India. Previously, I discussed about Devegowda, and I'm continuing the series of Prime Ministers of India. And I'm going to discuss about Inder Kumar Gujral. Inder Kumar Gujral was born on 4th December 1919 in a Punjabi Hindu Khatri family to Atwar Nair and Vasun Gujral in the village of Pari Jaisan Jalam in Punjab in British India. He studied at the DAV College, Haile College of Commerce and Foreign Criticism College, Lahore, all around the University of the Punjab. As a student, he became a member of the Communist Party of India. He also has two sisters, Oma Nanda and Sunan John. On 26th May 1945, Inder Kumar Gujral married to Saila Gujral, 24th of January till 24th of January to 24th of January 1924 till 11 July 2011, and had two sons, Naresh Gujral, born on 19 May 1948, who is Rajya Sabha MP, and Vishal Gujral, IKS Gujral's younger brother. Sustis Gujral was a world renowned painter and sculptor. Gujral became the vice president of the New Delhi Municipal Committee on 1958 and joined the Congress Party in 1964. He was close to Indira Gandhi and became a member of Rajya Sabha in April 1964. During the emergency of June 1975, Gujral was the Minister of Information of Barrow Costing. Where he was settled in the charge of area and recording of time of ownership in India and was charged of devolution. He again was selected to the Rajya Sabha to serve until 1976. He also served as a water resources minister. Later, Gujral was appointed to the Administration of India to the Soviet Union by Indira Gandhi and stayed during the tenure of Morarji Desai and Charan Singh, whose biographies are already covered. So, and subsequent to the 1966 election, when the United Front government was formed under the suspension of H.D. Devegowda, whose biography is covered, Gujral was again named Minister of External Affairs. During this tenure, he developed the Gujral discipline, which was better than regime with India's neighborhood, which he became Prime Minister. The Indian National Congress Party had been supporting the United Front government from outside, but cutting its wish to become the Prime Minister decided to withdraw support. This led to the government's council in April 1997. To avoid midterm elections, a committee was released. The INC agreed to support the another united front of the government under a new leader, provided plans such as not being constituted before taking important decisions and being address, the United Front was elected Gujral as the new leader, and he was sworn in as the Prime Minister on 21st of April 1997 at 2 a.m. Gujral was admitted at Medra Hospital in Goron, Haryana, part of the national capital religion, on 19 November 2012, after being diagnosed with a lung infection. He had suffered serious chest infection in few days before being admitted to hospital more than a year earlier. Gujral died on 30 November 2012, 4 days before his 93rd birthday, at the age of 92. His body lay in the state of his affection 5 months until noon the next day. So this is my lecture of I.K. Gujral as finished. Next lecture will be of Atal Bihari Vajpayee. This is Jayamayu Dadanani signing off.